Picture this. You have a dream. A dream to be the top sprinter in the world. For years you trained, early mornings, endless drills, all working to achieve this dream. And yet, you couldn't shake the feeling like there was something holding you back. Something in your DNA that made you different. What if I told you that this was closer to reality than you expect? That by looking at a single gene, your ace gene, we could predict what type of sport you would excel most in. Wouldn't you want to know? Join me today as we dive into the genetics behind sports success. Welcome to the genetic basis of stuff and things. Your body is like a factory. It uses your DNA as instructions for how the factory operates. Your genes are like a specific section of this manual, telling each part of the factory how to make specific products, or in this case, proteins. But sometimes, mistakes happen, and different factories or people can end up with different instructions. We call these polymorphisms, the variations in our genetic sequences. Over the past few decades, a lot of work has gone into learning about which polymorphisms, if any, were able to predict physical performance. After all, who wouldn't want to know the identity of these supergenes? But for a while, it seemed like this was an impossible task, until lo and behold, a paper was published in 1998 that did exactly that. Enter Montgomery and his team. They used DNA extracted from mouthwash samples from elite mountaineers and conducted a 3-primer polymerase chain reaction to amplify their DNA. When they compared these genotypes to control data, they found statistically significant differences in their allele frequency, meaning that this polymorphism was more likely to appear in elite mountaineers. And the gene in question? Your ACE. Your ACE is a key player in the regulation of blood pressure via the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, or RAS for short. This system of hormones originates from the liver and kidneys and is critical for the balance of body fluids. Your ACE, or angiotensin-converting enzyme, is the last piece of the puzzle. It cleaves the inactive angiotensin 1 into the bioactive angiotensin 2, which goes on to act throughout the body, increasing your blood pressure. So the more ACE your body produces, the faster your blood pressure is able to increase. The gene that encodes for the ACE is located on the 17th of the 23 pairs of chromosomes. It is 21,313 base pairs in length and consists of 26 exons and 25 introns. As of 2018, we have been able to describe more than 160 polymorphisms of this gene. The specific polymorphism we care about takes place on intron 17 of the gene. It is classified as an indel, meaning you either have the insertion sequence or you don't. Montgomery and his team found that the insertion allele had a significantly higher frequency among elite mountaineers, with excess of the homozygous insertion genotype and deficiency of the homozygous deletion genotype. Now, this was a huge breakthrough at the time. Never before had a correlation between a gene and a tangible phenotype been found. Hundreds of researchers jumped on this ACE bandwagon to try and further analyze the significance of this polymorphism. And one by one, other studies into the ACE gene began publishing their findings, and with it, another trend started to appear. It was found that the insertion allele correlated to improved endurance performance as a result of lower ACE activity, whilst the deletion allele correlated to improved strength-based performance. For example, a study conducted by Woods in 2001 looked specifically at the deletion allele in elite swimmers. They found an excess of the deletion allele in short-distance, power-oriented swimmers that was not present over larger distances. Wow, that sure is interesting. But what does this mean for me? Does this mean if I don't have two deletion alleles, I can't be a sprinter? Well, actually no. These traits are often complex when it comes to their expression. There are many other genes, as well as environmental and developmental factors, that impact you and your success. Your ACTN3, more commonly known as the speed gene, is another famous example of this. It encodes the structural protein alpha-actinin-3 that interacts with actin, a key protein for muscle contraction. It is especially important within your fast-twitch muscle fibers, which aids in short, explosive muscle contractions. Researchers found that roughly 16% of the world have a single nucleotide polymorphism, or SNP for short, in exon 16 of the gene. This results in a premature stop codon instead of the amino acid arginine, making a shortened, highly unstable version of the ACTN3. In 2003, it was demonstrated in a paper by Young that improved human athletic performance correlated with the healthy version of this gene. Despite all this, it is still a stretch to say that any single polymorphism could significantly influence your performance in any given area. All we can say right now is that based on the statistics, there seems to be a correlation between this genotype and this result. So just because you don't have the right ACE or ACTN3 allele, it doesn't mean you can't excel. And it certainly doesn't mean that just because you have the right genes, you're going to become a star. We don't know exactly why some of these polymorphisms lead to the results that they do. But hey, just because we don't know why something happens, doesn't mean we can't use it towards our advantage. And this is where self-knowledge can be extremely valuable. If you know which polymorphisms negatively affect your performance, you can adjust your training to mitigate them. With smart training, you can redefine the limits set by your genetics and unlock your full potential.